the head of the creek and I'm going up to see her about 2 times a week. Kiss her on the mouth, sweet as any wine. Wrap herself around me like a sweet potato vine. I'm
going up Cripple Creek, going in a run. Going up Cripple Creek, have a little fun. Going up Cripple Creek, going in a whirl. Going up Cripple Creek, see my girl.
Up a Cripple Creek about half grown.
Jump on a boy like a dog on a bone.
Roll my britches up to my knees.
Wait, oh Cripple Creek, whenever I please. I'm going up Cripple Creek, going in a run. Going up Cripple Creek to have a little fun. Going up Cripple Creek, going in a whirl. Going up Cripple Creek to see my girl.
Cripple Creek's wide and the Cripple Creek's deep.
Oh, wait, oh, Cripple Creek, before I sleep.
Hills are steep and the roads are muddy and
I'm so dizzy that I can't stand steady. I'm going up Cripple Creek, going in a run. Going up Cripple Creek to have a little fun. Going up Cripple Creek, going in a whirl. Going up Cripple Creek to see my girl.
Think of that, Fred. Not bad, huh? I like you too.
A demonstration by the Pink Panther. Clever, the letter K for the word karate.
Alec-a-roo, alec-a-rack, skid-a-ma-roo, skid-a-ma-rack, boom, ba, dippity-day, let's give a cheer for good old K! Yay, K! Yay!
Danger,
danger,
to the way from danger.
Danger,
oh, you better be than 12.
Charlie, if she's able to do this, I'll eat my... What? Oh, hi out there. Our Kermit the Frog here to report on one of the world's greatest athletic events, where in just a few moments, you're going to see an actual cow jump over the moon. Yeah, that's what you're going to see right here, folks. Maybe you've heard about this classic feat before. You know, they wrote a poem about it that went, hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon. Oh. The crowd is roaring. Here they come now. They're coming in now.
Make way for the cow. Make way for the jumping cow. And here she is, folks. The jumping cow.
Now, listen. That crowd roars.
Stand over there, Henry.
Pardon me. May I ask the cow a few questions?
I'm her manager, Frog. What do you want to know?
Just why is it Mrs. Cow?
I call her Natalie.
Call me Natalie.
How come, Natalie? How come is it that you want to jump over the moon? How come?
Because it's there. Because I want to prove that we cows can do anything we set our minds to.
Uh-huh. Terrific answer, kid.
People think we do nothing but moo and give milk all day. But they're wrong. We can do anything we set our minds to.
I believe it.
Yeah. All right, everybody stand by. It is time for the jump. Ready, okay. Sweetheart?
All systems go, Cap.
Then let's have a fanfare, please. All right, thank you. Countdown for the moon.
It's a very exciting moment, folks.
All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Good luck, baby. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off!
Wow! Here she goes! She cleared the tower, a beautiful liftoff. She's 13 miles downrange now. All systems green, approaching first stage shutdown.
Head away, baby!
The G-forces are decreasing. We have escape velocity and translunar insertion. And there she goes! Lunar gravity is taking over. She's reaching apogee. She's over the moon!
She did it!
And now she's starting a return flight. Or should I say plunge? Here she comes, folks. She should be contacting Earth's atmosphere at any moment. The retros are firing. Splashdown! There you have it, folks. The cow jumped over the moon.
Oh, a small jump for cow, a giant leap for cowdom.
You're right, sweetheart.
Ooh, you don't know the hoof of it.
Well, that's all from here. Kermit the Frog reporting. Tune in next week for the first annual Jack and Jill Hill Climb.
Let's get out of here.
On. Into. Under. Through. Around and around and around and around and around and around and around. K.
key. Huh. Aha.
Okay, is everybody here at the Grouch Club?
Yeah!
Yes!
Okay, into your seats there. Because today's topic, kiddies, is brothers and sisters.
Yes!
Do any of you have brothers or sisters?
Yeah,
okay. Now, what I want to ask you is, what does your brother or sister do that makes you mad? You know? Okay, I'll tell you what. Billy. What does your brother or sister do that makes you mad, huh?
My brother always beats me up.
He beats you up? Whoa. Gee, Danny, anything happen to you with your brothers or sisters?
Yeah, my brother always takes things away from me when I'm
Oscar!
Yeah.
I have a little sister
you
and
have
a big sister.
Yeah? What happens?
She's 7 years old, and another one is 12 years old, and...
What do they do to make you angry?
And she takes her... When I buy something of Alexander's, my Joanne takes it away from me, and she likes it. And my little sister, Tanya, she takes away my toys when I buy them.
And that makes you mad, huh?
Hi, Oscar. Hi, kids. How are you? What are you guys talking about?
Well, this is the Grouch Club, and they're telling me all the things that their brothers and sisters do that makes them mad.
Oh, you guys were talking about your brothers and sisters,
yeah?
Well, yeah, but you were talking about what makes you mad about them?
Yeah. Great subject.
Yeah, but wait a minute. There are things that are nice about your brothers and sisters, too, aren't there?
Nice.
Hey, can you guys name some things that are nice about your brothers and sisters?
Leapfrog.
What did you say, Danny?
Leapfrog.
Yeah.
Leapfrog and playing hide and seek.
There you go. See, so there are some nice things about your brothers and sisters too. They don't just make you mad.
Huh? You mean you're telling me that you're not so mad at your brothers and sisters as you were?
Yeah.
Oh, how do you like that?
Look.
Just when I had some good grouching going, someone has to come along and spoil it. Huh? Ow.
Hey, Ernie. Stop it, Ernie. Hey, Ernie. Hey, come on now. Cut that out, will you?
What?
Look at this mess, Ernie.
What mess?
I tell you, you are the sloppiest person I ever saw.
Ooh.
Now, if you don't get busy and clean this place up, I'm going to move in with Oscar.
What?
His garbage can is neater than this place.
Oh, well.
Wow.
Okay, Bert.
Boy.
I'll clean it up so clean you wouldn't recognize it.
Ha.
Well, I tell you, when I'm done, you could eat off the floor.
Ha, ha, ha. I'll believe that when I see it.
Okay, well, you just go and let me get to work here.
Okay.
Well, I'll clean
sure
it up.
Sure you do.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Mm-hmm. K. Kick.
Okay, and there we go.
Hey, Ernie, this is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I have never seen any place that looks so good.
Right.
Hey, are you finished?
Oh, almost, Bert. The only thing left is my toy box.
Well, go to it. This is beautiful.
I gotta clean up my toy box now. Let's see, we got my rubber ducky here. And down here, my tinfoil ball. I got my X to mark the spot. And that's my Spot. That's my dog. That's his name, you know. Down here, I got my worm collection. I don't want to forget that. Over here, we got my paperclip collection, old tape, my football helmet. Down here, we got, there's my peanut butter sandwich. And over here, we got,
breath. Smell the smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. You can move your feet to walk, and you use your tongue to talk, but your mouth and nose are waiting. Take a breath. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. You can move your teeth to chew, but your face is turning blue. Get some air inside of you, just take a breath. You never think of breathing, though you do it all day long. You even have to breathe to sing this funny little song. You've got to take a breath before you try to blow a bubble. And if you stop your breathing, you got big, big trouble. So take a good deep breath. That's better. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. There are many ways to play, but you're growing every day, and you need some ventilation, take a breath. You got to do your breathing, take a breath. Take a breath.
See, under the present Dewey Decimal System, this book belongs...
Wow! Look at all these books! Me never seen so many books before!
Shh!
Hmm? Oh, yeah, yeah, right, right.
All right. Quiet, please!
I did not see wastebasket.
All right.
Excuse me, sir? Sir?
Hmm?
Could you tell me what you're doing with all these books here?
Well, this is a library. Yes, yes, people come here to borrow books they'd like to read.
Oh, that's terrific!
Hmm.
This library!
Yes.
Oh, well, that's great because me try hard to read.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah.
Now, what can I get you?
Well, me want a book about Little Red Riding Hood.
All right.
And one box of cookies, please.
Maybe you don't understand. You see, this is a library.
Yeah?
Yes, we have books here. Only books. We have no cookies.
Oh. Oh.
You understand?
Me see. Okay.
Right.
Okay. Then let's see. Me take book of nursery rhymes.
All right.
And a box of cookies, please.
We don't have cookies. We only have books. Just books. No cookies. All right?
Oh, no, oh, yeah, right, right, got it now, okay. Then, let's see, me take a picture book.
Picture book.
Yeah, and a box of cookies.
How many times do I have to tell you we don't have cookies? Only books.
Oh, okay.
Just books,
okay.
No cookies.
Okay, no get upset, okay? Don't get excited, me not fussy.
All right?
Just give me box of cookies.
No! We don't have cookies! No cookies! Just books! That's all! No cookies! Understand? Just books! Books!
You know what? Me get feeling you only have books.
That's right! Just books!
Me got it. Me got it now. Okay, okay.
All right.
Good.
At last.
Good.
Now, what do you want?
Me want book about cookies.
Fine. That we have. A book about cookies. Good.
And a glass of milk, please. A book about cookies and a glass of juice?
Plus 1 equals 2. Plus 1 equals 3. 3 trapeze artists. Take away 1 equals 2. Take away 1 equals 1.
1. Ladies and gentlemen, Magical Herman.
Thank you, thank you, thank you very much, thank you. This is the number 1. Not bad, huh? Take this number 1, add it to this one, and presto! The number 2. I take another number 1, add it to the 2, and presto! The number 3. I take yet another 1, add it to the 3, and presto! A good-looking number 4. I take another number 1, add it to the 4, and presto! Oh, number 5. Onward. Take another 1, add it to the 5, shoot a little presto, there's the 6. I take another 1, add it to the 6, wave these talented fingers, there's a very handsome 7. I take another 1, add it to the 7, presto, ha-ha, an 8. Now I add another 1, like this. Presto, zappo, number 9. I take this one, I add it to the 9, like this. The big 10! Thank you. Oh, Herman, they love you, they love you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
And now the game show you've been waiting all morning to see, the Addition Game. And here's our own star of daytime television, Guy Smiley.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, yes, you're a wonderful audience. Thank you. Welcome to the Addition Game, where it always adds up to fun and prizes. All right. Okay, and now let's meet our first contestant, Mr. Harry Monster from Sesame Street. Hello, there, Harry Monster! How are you today?
Fine, thank you, Guy.
And are you ready to play the addition game?
Ready, Guy.
All right, let's look at the board and see what your first question will be. The question is, how much is 1 + 1?
1 + 1.
Yes, or another way to ask it, if I had one apple and someone gave me one more apple, how many apples would I have?
Two, yes. 1 + 1 = 2 apples.
You think it's two? Let's look at the addition board. 1 + 1 = 2. You're absolutely right, Harry Monster. Wonderful, wonderful. All right, are you ready for your next question?
Ready, Guy.
All right, let's look at the addition board, and the next question is, how much is 2 + 1?
2 + 1.
Yes, and another way to think about that one, suppose a farmer had 2 cows and he bought one more cow, how many cows would he have?
2 + 1 = 3, Guy.
You think it's 3? Look at the addition board. 2 + 1 = 3. You're absolutely right, Harry Monster. Wonderful.
Listen,
are you ready for the jackpot question?
Oh, I'm ready, Guy.
Because if you win this question, you get an all-expense-paid vacation for two to Milpitas, California, Harry Monster.
Hear that, Mom? Okay, all right. Ready.
Are you ready? Okay, here it comes. How much is 3 + 1?
Oh, 3 + 1.
Another way to think about that one, suppose there were 3 cars here.
3 cars?
And someone drove in one more car.
One more car?
How many cars would there be?
Oh, that's a toughie, Guy.
Well, you didn't think it would be easy, did you?
3 cars, and then one more car.
Yes?
Oh, the time...
I'm sorry, Harry Monster, your time is up. Too bad. Let's look at the answer anyhow. 3 + 1 = 4.
3 + 1 = 4?
Yes, always.
You don't mind if I check this out, do you?
What?
Stay right here. Don't go away. I'll be right back.
All right, well, thank you for playing our game. Now let's meet our next contestant, Mrs. Frances Osnowitz from Great Falls, Montana.
Thank you. Welcome
to the addition game, Mrs. Osnowitz, and wait a minute. You don't suppose it couldn't be?
Okay, that's 1. I'll be right back.
Goodness gracious!
What on earth is going on? Oh, no!
Okay, that's 2. Wait a minute, be right back.
Is this a Triborough Bridge?
He's not really doing this, is he? Oh, no!
Hot rodder?
Yeah, that's 3. Be right back.
What is going on?
What is this?
Where did I lose control? Oh, no!
Let's see. 1, 2, 3 cars plus 1 car. You're right. It equals 4 cars. Well... You're a good sport, Guy. Thanks,
what is going on here?
Well, join us again next time.
Hey, would you tell me what is going on?
My name is Kent. I get a kick out of being king of the forest.
One of these things is not like the others. Which one is different? Do you know? Tell me which thing is not like the others, and I'll tell you if it is so.
3 of these things are starfish, but this is a crab. Hey, man, where you going?
Can you do this? Oh. Hey, Luis.
Hi, Pajaro.
What you doing? Babysitting for little Dakota?
Yeah, sure am.
Hi, little Dakota. You're a nice little baby. Hey, you sure are little. I sure am big, because I'm a big bird. Coochie-coochie-coo. He's smaller than me. He's smaller than me. There's so much that he doesn't know. I'm taller than he. Much taller than he. But I'm going to help him to grow. When I was a baby, I looked that way too. Just sleeping and eating was all I could do. I grew to be older and learned lots of things, like walking and talking, hiding and sliding, and pumping on swings, like making up stories, like climbing up poles, like filling a sandbox and digging big holes. Yes, now that I'm older, I know lots of things, like buttoning buttons and putting on socks, like skipping and hopping and building with blocks, like eating with knives and with forks and with spoons, like knowing my name and blowing up balloons. It's wonderful how I grew up to be me. I'll help little Dakota. He's smaller than me. Coochie coochie coo.
It's a triangle. Now it's lots of triangles. There's a triangle. What's that? It's a seesaw. Look at the bottom of it. It's a triangle. The cone is shaped like a triangle. Triangle. Beak is a triangle. Hey, there's another triangle. Now it's a triangle, triangle. It sounds nice. Blink. Bye, triangle.
Going to imagine shapes today.
We go what?
We're going to imagine four different shapes, and the first one is a circle.
Oh, circles! I like circles, yes.
Don't do that. Oh. Now, do you know what a circle looks like?
Yeah, well, I know, yeah. A circle, it looks round. Yeah,
yes,
circles
now,
is round.
Watch closely, I'm about to imagine a circle.
Imagine on, baby.
Here we go. We start over here, you see? If I can imagine it. It's kind of hard. It goes around like this and goes up again like that and meets that there. Ah, there, a circle. Now let's see you imagine a circle.
I can imagine a circle. Erase yours.
All right, there.
Ready? Zap, zap, zip, bow. Look at that. This is fun.
Very good. Stop it. All right, get those away from me. All right, stop that. All right, that will do. Get those out of here. Erase them right now. Erase them.
All right.
All right, now the next shape to imagine is a rectangle.
Ooh! Oh! Rectangle!
You please stop that. Now, this here is a rectangle, and I'll show you. We start over here, you see, we go all the way over here with this line, and then we go down, and we go over here with another long line, and then we go up and meet there. Ooh. Well, that is a rectangle.
Hey, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Can rectangles go up to down instead of sideways to sideways?
Of course.
All right, then erase yours.
All right, there.
Watch this. Zap, zoo-dow, zoo-ba-doo.
Oh, that's very good, what's that? What is that?
No, what is it? It's design.
A design.
I'm decorating it.
Well, we don't need that. Just stop those dots. Get rid of it.
Yeah,
erase
right,
it.
All right,
erase
all
it.
Right, all right.
All right, now we are going to imagine triangles now.
Ow! Triangle's my favorite
please
thing.
Please stop that. Now, here's the triangle. Start over here, go up, and then we meet the other... There. All right. Now you try a triangle.
All right. Here we go. Yeah. Hey, you know what that looks like?
What?
You can have. It looks like that. So, ooh,
all right.
Baby, got my music.
Stop the music. Stop that. That'll do. But we don't need that. All right, stop it now. Stop.
All right. Do you like this?
What's that? Oh, it's better.
It's a catchy tune.
Yeah, well, let's just throw it away, okay? Erase it. The whole thing.
All right,
All right. Now, the last shape we're going to imagine is a square. Do you know what a square is?
I know who a square is.
No, that's cute. Now, let's see you imagine a square, then.
All right. Zabada.
Yes.
Very good. I need my guitar back. Zabada.
Woo! Hello there.
Hi there! I'm here to tell you about the letter Z. That's the letter Z. Do you know what word starts with the letter Z? The word zebra! And here comes a zebra now! Do you know where you can find a zebra? It's another word that begins with Z.
Peacock.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Said the alligator king to his seven sons, I'm feeling mighty down. Whichever of you can cheer me up will get to wear my crown. His first son brought seven oyster pearls from the bottom of the China Sea. The second gave him seven statues of girls with clocks where their stomachs should be. The third son gave him seven rubies from the sheikdom of down there beneath. The king thought the rubies were cherries, and he broke off seven of his teeth. The fourth son tried to cheer him up with seven lemon drops. The king said,
I'm sorry, son, since that ruby episode, I just haven't got the chops.
The fifth son brought the king perfume in seven fancy silver jars. The king took a whiff and he broke out in spots, 'cause it smelled like cheap cigars. The sixth son gave him seven diamond rings to wear upon his toes. The king snagged his foot on the royal red rug and crumpled up his nose. The seventh son of the alligator king was a thoughtful little whelp. He said,
Daddy, appears to me that you could use a little help.
Said the alligator king to his seventh son, my son, you win the crown. You didn't bring me diamonds or rubies, but
You helped me up when I was down. Take the crown, it's yours, my son. Hope you don't mind the dents. I got it on sale at a discount store. Cost me all of 7 cents. Seven.
What you doing, Buffy?
I'm feeding the baby. See, he's drinking milk from my breast.
Oh, that's a funny way to feed a baby.
Well, lots of mothers feed their babies this way. Not all mothers, but lots of mothers do.
Oh.
And he likes it because it's nice and warm and sweet and natural. And it's good for him. And I get to hug him when I do it, see?
Oh. Well, is that all he ever needs to eat?
Well, at first, when he was just born and very tiny, this is all that he wanted and all that he needed. But now that he's getting bigger, see, I mash up fruit and vegetables and sometimes a little bit of meat. And as he gets older, he'll need more and more different kinds of food to eat. But for right now, this is just fine. He's drinking his milk.
You know, that's nice.
Estoy llorando.
No, estoy llorando.
I am crying.
I am crying?
No, I am crying.
Estoy llorando.
I am crying.
Estoy llorando.
I am crying.
I am crying?
Estoy llorando?
Estoy llorando. I am crying.
I am crying. Estoy llorando.
No estoy llorando.
I am not crying.
No estoy llorando. I am not crying.
I am not crying. No estoy llorando.
What's this place? It's a lot of wires. Yeah, a lot of wires. What's she doing?
I don't know.
She looks like she's fixing the wires.
Yeah, she's a person who fixes the wires.
Now she's checking some other wires.
Now she's listening to something.
That's what she's doing. She's checking all the wires to see if they're working.
I maintain and repair telephone circuits for the telephone company.
Okay, your number's falling! Here, hush! Come on!
One, two,
three,
four!
Addies, what's your number?
Five.
Speak up, number five.
Five.
That's better. Carry on.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
11.
Addies, you're not 11, you're 9. Can't you tell a 9 from an 11? Carry on.
9.
10.
11.
12.
13.
14.
15.
16.
18.
Addies! Where is 17?
Wake up, 17.
Huh? Fall in with the rest of the numbers. Carry on with 17.
17.
18.
19.
20.
All numbers 1 to 20 present and accounted for. Numbers 1 to 20 dismissed. Yay!
Thank you.
Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
Oh, Ernie. What are you doing with those cookies in bed, huh?
Well, the cookies, well, I was just hungry, Bert, so I thought I'd have a few cookies before I went to sleep.
Ernie, don't eat those cookies while you're in your bed, huh?
Why not, Bert?
Because you get crumbs in the sheets, that's why.
Gee, Bert, I get crumbs in the sheets?
Yeah, Ernie, and if there are crumbs in the sheets, they'll get in your pajamas.
Ooh, crumbs in my pajamas, Bert?
Yeah, Ernie, and if you get crumbs in your pajamas, they'll make you itch, you know that.
I don't like to itch, Bert.
No, and if you itch, you won't be able to sleep, Ernie, so don't do it, okay? Good night.
Oh, gee, if I eat the cookies in bed, I'll get crumbs in my sheets. And if I get crumbs in the sheets, I'll get crumbs in my pajamas. And if I get crumbs in my pajamas, I'll itch, and I won't be able to sleep. Oh, Bert, thank you so much for stopping me from eating cookies in my bed.
All right, Ernie, just go to bed, though, okay?
Okay. And I'm never going to eat cookies in my bed again.
Okay, good. Ernie, what are you doing?
I'm going to eat cookies in your bed, Bert. Move over.
Can you count up to 20? How high can you count?
Yes, I know how to count up to 20.
Can you count up to 20?
Yeah.
Let's hear you. Start off.
One.
One, that's a good beginning. Two.
Two.
Three. Three, yeah.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
11.
You got pretty eyes.
So do you. Well, what comes after 11?
12. 14,
15, 16. No, wait. What comes after 12? 13.
13.
Yep.
14.
14, yeah. Then what?
16?
Mm-mm.
Which?
I think 15.
What?
15.
15.
15, yeah.
Okay,
what comes after 15?
16.
Then what comes after 16?
17.
17.
18.
19.
20.
20! Wonderful, we made it.
I live on a pueblo in New Mexico. My name is James, and I'm a Cochiti Indian. This is my mama. This is my daddy. I have two sisters, Christine and Georgia. My people have lived on this land for as long as anyone can remember. Sometimes it seems like the dogs want to go to school with us. And I meet all my friends here after school.
My favorite Indian game is shimmy stick. Mama makes the best tortillas in the whole Pueblo. Them instead of bread. After dinner, I do my homework while Mama and Grandma make necklaces out of corn. They sell them to the people that visit our pueblo in the summertime. I like to play and read. I also like to sleep.
Okay, Grouch Club, you're gonna repeat everything I say here. Sesame Street has been brought to you today.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today.
By the rotten letter K.
By the rotten letter K.
And by the revolting letter Z.
And by the revolting letter Z.
And by the regusting number 7.
And by the regusting number 7.
Yeah. Sesame Street is a production of...
Sesame Street is a production of...
The Children's Television Workshop.
The Children's Television Workshop.
Okay, you're gonna keep doing it over and over until you get it wrong.